So today's discussion is about communications in plants. Three main types of communications will be discussed here: from organ to organ, from cell to cell, and within the cell. Now, first of all, it is very important for you to understand that why communication takes place by the plant body, or why plant cells communicate. As you know that without any doubt, leaves are the main photosynthetic organs of plants. They are responsible for the transport of carbohydrates to all parts of plant body, which are used by them for energy formation. Similarly, water and nutrients which are absorbed by plant roots, they also need to be transported to the aerial parts. So, water and nutrients and carbohydrates are demand of each and every organ in each and every cell of plant body. So, in order to accomplish it, plants use a specific kind of tissues which are known as vascular tissues, and these vascular tissues like phloem and xylem, they are responsible for the transport of these nutrients within the plant body. Another kind of transport which takes place from one cell to next is achieved through the pores or spaces which are present on the cell wall, and these spaces or pores are known as plasmodesmata. You can expect generally 1000 to 10,000 plasmodesmata present on the cell wall of a single plant cell. Another kind of transport which is known as intracellular transport or communication, it takes place through a system of intrinsic proteins which are not only present on the plasma membrane, but they are present on the membranes of all organelles. So, in order to further clarify the concept of intracellular communication, you can see here that in the plasma membrane, these intrinsic proteins or porins, they are shown in different colors in order to show their diversity, because there are so many kinds of porins which are present or not only on the plasma membrane, but they are also present on the vacuolar membrane or tonoplast, or the chloroplast membrane, or the mitochondrial membrane, or the nuclear membrane. So, the concept is that the energy formation which takes place in the mitochondria or ATP formation, once synthesized in the matrix, it need to be transported through the cytosol to the all organelles, because many important metabolic pathways are taking place in these organelles which are dependent upon the ATP transport. And in order to transport this ATP from one organelle to the next, a system of porins or intrinsic proteins is used. Similarly, these intrinsic proteins are basically of three kinds. They are either carriers, they are either channels, or they are pumps. Now, the carriers and channels differ, that carriers are membrane proteins which show high substrate specificity, while channels show low substrate specificity. And pumps are actually kind of intrinsic proteins which are dependent upon energy, generally in the form of ATP. Now, the extracellular communication, or from one cell to next cell communication, takes place by means of plasmodesmata. Here you can see that plasmodesmata are shown in blue structure. Plasmodesmata are actually extension of smooth endoplasmic reticulum, and they form a tube, and this tube is known as desmotubule, which passes from one cell to the next. Now, there are two school of thoughts that how actually the transport of material takes place through the plasmodesmata. It is still not clear that either it takes place from inside of desmotubule or through the space or the cytoplasmic sleeve from one cell to the next. Now, the plasmodesmata may be primary plasmodesmata or secondary plasmodesmata. You can see here that these are secondary plasmodesmata which are branched. So, if you see on the surface view, plasmodesmata appear like this. This is another example of intracellular communication, which is showing that ATP formation, which takes place in the mitochondria, its transport takes place from mitochondria to the other organelles. In addition to this, channels for the transport of molecules or the pigments are also present in petals, and sometimes they are dependent upon hydrogen ion concentration, sometimes they are dependent upon pH, and sometimes in the case of tulip, they are dependent upon ferrous concentration, like the low ferric ion concentration within the petals of some plants, they are responsible for giving them purple coloration, while the high ferric ion concentration is responsible for the blue coloration. Similarly, in the case of Ipomoea, red color is due to low pH, while the blue color is due to the high pH. Thank you.